Hi guys, I'm Rachel over at that 1870s Homestead, and today we are going to be canning up a bag of fish that is probably a year old and been sitting in my freezer. So the reason why I'm doing this is I don't think I have any tuna fish in stock. Tuna fish is something that we eat often, and I need to free up freezer space. So I recently watched somebody on YouTube can some whitefish, and he showed how he made it just into like tuna fish for quick and easy sandwiches. I thought that's a great use. So what I have today is a 2 pound bag of individually like freezer packed slices of cod, and I'm going to be chopping that up. We're going to be pressure canning it, and that's about it. Maybe one day I'll do a follow-up video where I make it into tuna fish. So let's get going and we'll see how it turns out. Okay, well, the 2 pounds gave me right at 4 half pints. Just wiping the lids right now with vinegar to clean it off from any fish juice. And then we're gonna add a little pinch of salt to each jar. You don't have to add salt, but I'm fine with it. You don't add any liquid, just whatever liquid the fish makes. And you do want about an inch head space. I think there's some rule that when you're working with half pints, you need like at least 4 jars in your canner. If you guys have ever heard that rule and you know it to be true, let me know down in the comments. Just finger tight with your lids. And we'll have 4 little jars of tuna fish. And we'll come back and show you guys how it is when it's done. Okay, well, the canner's been venting now for 10 minutes, so I'm gonna go ahead and put the pressure stopper on it and let this come up to about 10 pounds of pressure, and we're going to pressure can for 70 minutes. Okay, well, it's been time enough for the pressure to release and the pressure canner. So I'm just gonna show you guys the end results. I only got the 4 half pints. Careful, it's steamy in there. And again, just a reminder, no liquid was added to this. It's just the liquid that the fish produced itself. I think they said with, like white fish like this, a non-greasy fish, you could add a little bit of oil. I did not do that. I just added a little bit of salt.
And then fishes like salmon or herring or things that are oily fishes naturally, you don't have to add oil. I didn't do it either way. Anyway, so my challenge to you is look through your freezer. What's going to go bad soon? Get it out of the freezer, can it? That's what I'm doing. Talk to you guys later.